Hi everyone, Massimo here from the Bluroot team. And today I have a really exciting app to talk about. It's one that's growing more and more in the Zoho ecosystem, and that's Zoho Subscription. What I'm gonna do in this video is talk about how to set up Zoho Subscriptions from scratch. So in it, I'll go over what is Zoho Subscription, how to set it up, what are plans, what are subscriptions, what are hosted pages, some of the preferences. I'm basically going to take you from nothing to set up to the point where you could run a SaaS business and collect payment from clients. So as always, please like, comment, subscribe. We love hearing from you. We love commenting back. And turn on your notification. If you subscribe to us, make sure you do that. You'll hear about all of our newest videos. We're bringing out at least one a week. And also join our office hours. There will be a link in the description below. The office hours are a time for you to meet me, ask me questions, basically ask me anything Zoho, and I'd love to help you. Have a good one. Enjoy the video. Okay. So this is the first page you'll see when you first go into Zoho Subscriptions. So when you first set it up, and in order to set it up, just go to subscriptions.zoho.com or from your Zoho One, turn it on. And so they ask you some basic questions here. This will just kind of help you set things up. And at a high level, what Zoho Subscriptions is think of it, well, it's a subscription billing software, right? So it integrates with Zoho Books. All of the invoices and all of that will automatically trickle into Zoho Books. And what it basically does is it visualizes all of your subscriptions, how many you have per month, when they're renewing. It allows you to automate emails to clients, hey, your subscription's renewing. It allows you to collect payment from clients. And it also allows you to build like subscription hosted pages or landing pages for clients to fill out, and then their data comes into the system. Now, you can sell all kinds of things on a subscription, right? And that's what it's showing here. So you can do SaaS, you can do physical goods, you can do IT, you can do memberships, all kinds of stuff, right? And so what I'm gonna go through in this example anyways, I'm just gonna pretend we're a SaaS business, right? So I'm gonna choose that. Then you're gonna fill out some stuff. This is just locale stuff. This will help them determine taxes and certain settings. Certain countries have different settings than others. I'm gonna choose my time zone, your preferred language, fiscal year. This doesn't really matter. Well, it does for you, but for this video, it doesn't. You can upload your logo. You'll hit continue. And then it'll pop you into Zoho Subscriptions. So there's a couple things right off the bat that it tries to get you to do. So number one, client portal. Just so you understand what this is, Zoho Subscriptions actually has a feature within it where you can invite your clients to a portal. They can upgrade, they can downgrade, they can manage their subscriptions, add users, all kinds of stuff like that. So what it's asking here is just to put a name to your portal. So you can see here, it's gonna say subscriptions, blah, 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 backslash, and then you can actually put a name. So you can personalize it a bit, not a big deal. But you can see here, it also has a nice walkthrough, and I'm gonna kind of follow this and add a bit more flavor to it. Creating a plan, creating add-ons, getting paid online, etc. And so what I'm gonna do first is just talk about products. So what's a product? Product is something you sell, right? Commodity or a service. So a product could be one user. For example, a product could be Zoho CRM, right? And then, or a service could be like hourly call or something, right? So phone call. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit add product. So the first thing it says is to name it. So I'm just going to say Zoho CRM. Now you can fill out all of this stuff. This is basically when someone signs up, you can put a notification mail address so someone can get an email when someone signs up. This is something you may want to do. Redirect URL is interesting. It's a bit more advanced. I would say for this video, I'm just going to leave it blank. And when you do, it'll just go to a generic page. But what you can actually do here is redirect people to certain pages you can see here. So you can actually redirect them to a certain page and then insert placeholders. So you can throw in the name or the transaction ID, the invoice number. So there might be use cases where when someone fills out information about the product, you then redirect them to their invoice. And that's what you could do here, right? So I'm just going to save. So now I've created a product, right? And so the product should be fairly general, because within a product, you can have plans, yearly, monthly, different flavors. For example, gold, silver, platinum, right? And so if I go ahead and hit add, using the Zoho CRM world, I could go Zoho CRM Enterprise. I'm gonna make these all monthly in this example. So I'm gonna go Zoho CRM. you can make a plan code. This is, it has to be unique. You can use any letter combination that you want. The unit here, it can be boxes or pieces or feet or centimeter. You don't have to fill this out. I'm gonna put it's $50. I'm gonna bill it every month. You can also choose week or year, right? And you can make it auto renew until canceled, or you could say this is just a 1 year thing, right? So if you're selling some type of educational something and the product is English course, and then the plan is 12 month boot camp or 12 week boot camp, then you could put a specified number of billing cycles. I would recommend choosing include in feature, or sorry, include in widget. This will be relevant in a little bit. Under the more fields here, just so you know, if you are using the Zoho accounting suite, you can actually choose more. These are like the GL codes and the general ledger codes. So in your profit and loss statement, do you want this to go into sales? Do you want it to go into subscription sales? You may have custom general ledgers that you want this to go into. Same with the setup field, setup fee. So there might be a setup fee if you want, and you can actually put that up here. So you can actually put a setup fee. You can also put a free trial, right? And so both of these will be at the plan level. And then we'll hit save. So now we've created a plan. And so now I'm gonna create another one. And I'm just gonna say Zoho CRM. There isn't really a right or wrong way to do this. I have seen people actually make it like Zoho CRM Enterprise is the product. And then one is monthly or yearly, right? So I can show that here. So if I cancel this, I'll make this Zoho CRM Enterprise. And then this will go. And then I can make another plan. Price 500. I'm gonna say every year and save. So now what I've done is I've set up a product and multiple plans. And one of the neat things with this now, it'll come in handy in a little bit, is you're slowly building out a product catalog. And this can actually be displayed online, which I'll show. So people can actually sign up for this product catalog in a really neat way. A couple other things in the products, you can add add-ons. So maybe someone has CRM Enterprise monthly, but they also want an add-on for texting or something, right? So you would just hit add add-on, and then when they're signing up, they can also add an add-on. Coupons as well. You do have to assign coupons and add-ons at the product level. So this product is allowed to have coupons and allowed to have add-ons. So that's where you would do this all right here. So you would go through and make many products, many plans, build out your kind of database of services or products, right? Couple cool things here. This share hosted payment page. First off, what you have to do is you actually have to set up a payment gateway. And so Zoho automatically accepts a bunch of them, right? So Stripe is probably their most popular. They also have PayPal, Go Cardless. All of these, I'm not gonna show in the video. They're very easy and there's a lot of really good walkthroughs that you can look at to set this up. You could see their transaction fees here. It'll bring you to their website pages. A lot of them charge like 2 to 3% on the credit card processing fee, but they're all really good. And some of them have strengths and weaknesses. I'm not gonna go through all of that today. But essentially, once you set that up, when you click this share hosted payment page, it'll actually give you a URL that you can put on your website that people can then click on and buy your product. And it's a really nice looking URL. I'm actually gonna pause this video and show you our, like an example of one of our hosted payment pages, just so you get a flavor. Here we are in mine. Here's one of our products. We have support that we sell to people. And you can see here, it gives you a URL. So what I did is hit share hosted payment page. It can be an embed, or it can be an HTML button that you put in an email. But just to show you the URL here, I paste it. This is what it would look like. And I'll show you how to customize all this. You can make the colors different, etc. But this, you could put in the button of your email, button on your website, something. People click it, it opens this up. And now it has the price there, it has the tax there, they put in all their information, they even put in their credit card information, and then you've created a subscription. So that's one of the neat things about Zoho Subscription. They actually allow you to manage all of this stuff, and they host it all for you. You don't have to worry about security or any of that. Zoho handles it. So that's what you would see once you set up all your credit card data or details. You would have these hosted payment pages. Price lists, I'm not gonna go through a bunch today, but basically you can assign certain price lists to your products. And then depending on the client, you can assign a price list. So you could say, well, the product is $50 in this plan, but I have a price list that's 10% off and I'm gonna apply it to these clients because they're part of a network or they're buying a lot from us or whatever. right? Customers is obvious. Subscriptions, once people start subscribing, they will list in here. So if I go to create a subscription for a sample customer here, you can see I'll just do a dummy email. You'll see here that you can choose a plan, right? So we only have two, and then it auto-fills. So that hosted payment page I showed you, when someone fills it out, they'll automatically create a subscription and a customer. But you can also manually do it on your end, right? And when you're going through this, it gives you a few options. So it says it never expires. You can collect payment offline. So this just sends them an invoice and they can send you a check, right? So that's relevant for this demo in the sense that some of you just want recurring subscriptions or recurring invoices to go out, but you don't want to collect payment. That's not how you work, or your payments are very large or whatever. And so you can just hit collect payment offline and it'll just start sending this out, or you can collect payment online or uncheck that box. And then it will actually, when you hit continue, it will actually get you to put the credit card details in. So you can have them over the phone, you can take them from a client, whatever. And so now you've set up a product, you've set up some plans. I'm gonna bring you through some of the other general settings that you should do before you get subscriptions really running. And by the way, it shows you a bunch of stuff that you can look at here. It just helps you visualize what's happening. So if I hit settings, first off in the preferences, I'd recommend looking at this, getting your branding right. Under subscriptions, maybe you don't want it to say sub, you want it to say something else. The customer portal is an interesting one. You can invite people to the customer portal. I'll probably make a small video just on this. It's a lot to cover in this longer video, but you can actually invite all of your customers to a customer portal and then they can actually manage their subscriptions in there. And within that, you can now, for example, choose what they're allowed to do. Are they allowed to just view their subscriptions, or are they allowed to upgrade or downgrade or cancel or pause? So there's all kinds of stuff that you can allow the customer to do in here. If you hit enable now, it'll have all kinds of check boxes for you to check off. Okay, I want them to upgrade, I want them to downgrade, etc. Under the products tab, the invoices tab, I'd recommend just taking a look at this. There are some interesting ones here. This one we actually use. Let's say people have more than one subscription with you, and one bills on the 18th and one bills on the first of the month. You can actually have consolidated billing where it'll combine multiple invoices into one and just send out at the first of the month, for example. And so this is a really handy feature, mostly from the client perspective, where they just get one bill and it'll prorate one of their subscriptions on that bill, depending on the term. So that's something really cool. And then this one here is also really neat, where depending on when the customer, let's say they buy one thing from you, then they buy a second thing. The first thing they buy from you will actually be the billing date. So they buy something from you on the 5th, then every month on the 5th, it's gonna recur. Let's say they buy a second thing from you on the 10th. Well, it's actually going to recur on the 5th and only bill for 25 days of the month because you've already gone from the 5th to the 10th. So there's a bunch of stuff you'll want to look at back here just to get right. Then I want to talk about templates. So templates, this is customizable. This is the invoice template, customer statement, etc. When you hit edit on this, you can customize a lot of stuff. So you can customize, for example, the header. So logo, do you want to show your name or not, like the business name? Do you want a background image? Do you want to have a background color? Right now it's white, but you can see, like, you can make it red and hit apply. So the header goes red, right? So you can customize all this stuff. You can choose what actually goes on the invoice. So you could choose due date. No, I don't want it, or I do. Reference field, we don't have POs, etc. So I'd recommend going through all of this, getting this right, getting the branding right for your business. Now, hosted payment pages, I think, is really relevant to talk about here. I kind of mentioned the hosted payment pages, but what it can do, you can actually customize these, right? So edit layout, you can see here, again, the branding I think is important. So you can have the checkout page completely branded, payment update page completely branded, and the thank you page, like when they actually sign up. So I'd recommend going through all of this. It's very similar. You click here, you update stuff. It's really, really good. The emails that go out is also a very important part that you should look at. And really what I would say is all of these templates, user invite, new subscription, these here, like if I click on this, you can actually see this is what it would look like. So some of you in your business may be very particular on how you want templates to look. So you should go here, take a look. You can go through all of these and actually customize them very easily. You can see there's a template editor here. There's actually a, so what it's doing here is putting in the plan name that they signed up for, but you can insert different placeholders. So you put the person's name or the person's or your name or the customer's name. So just by clicking this, it'll actually insert that merge field, which is very handy for personalizing. The reminders tab, definitely go through. This is when you're trying to get paid on stuff. Let's say someone's gone overdue, right? The invoice is due this day, they didn't pay. You can turn these on and it will remind them to pay. And again, you can customize these. I'd recommend looking at these. These are basically accounts receivable automations. You can have reminder for overdue invoices, reminder for sent invoices. The dunning management, I think you should definitely, I mean, it depends on the business, but basically what this means is, let's say you try to charge someone, it doesn't work. Their credit card's maxed out or got hacked and got canceled or whatever. You could see here, so it'll send them an email when the payment fails. If it's credit card, it'll send them this email. If they're paying with debit card, it'll send them this email. Then you can tell Zoho Subscriptions when to try again. First retry, 3 days later. If it fails, here's the template. Second retry, 3 days after that. If it fails, here's, et cetera, right? So you could do up to three of these. And then if everything doesn't go through, then what do you want to do, right? And so this is something that's super handy. Like, not every credit card transaction goes through the first time. This, speaking from experience, we have a lot of subscriptions. This has really helped us collect stuff. Online payments, I talked about. Integrations, you may want to look at this. You can actually integrate all this stuff back into books, into CRM, into Sales IQ. Sales IQ is like Zoho's live chat software. I have a video on it. I think we'll probably link it here. Something to check out. You can actually put like a live chat inside of the portal. So if people are having trouble with their bill, they can launch a live chat and speak with you, right? There's a bunch of stuff here. I don't think it's the most relevant for this video. What is becoming more and more popular is integrating with SMS. So you can actually connect this to a Twilio account and then send people reminders to pay their bills via SMS. This is something you should definitely look at if you do have a Twilio account, or even if you don't, you should check it out. People are really paying their bill quicker when getting a text, especially in the dunning management area. So kind of last thing I want to show you here is this here. What I just did, I went to the product. Now I have two plans and I can hit embed widget. This is really, really cool where you can actually display all of the, so let's say I had two plans that were monthly, right? So let me just make another one here. This is why this was relevant, including in widget, right? And so if I hit save now and I go to embed widget, you'll see there's two here, right? Again, you can change the color of this. You can change how it kind of shows, right? So you can like switch the order. You can configure the plans. So you can see here, you can configure different settings in it, add different currencies. And one of the areas that I kind of skipped over a little bit, you can change the theme. So some of the themes are like this, right? And then when you go here, you can actually put a star on one. So it'll like show most popular. And one of the neat things here that I'm kind of glancing over is when you actually make the plan, there is this description, right? And plan features, right? And I'll also put it here. So hit save. Now, if I go back to embed widget, you'll see hello YouTube. So that was that second part there that I showed. So you could have like a list, and you've probably seen it with certain things where you have like, it has lead management, it has this, it has that. So people very quickly can see what to buy, which plan they should buy. You can also have themes like this. And then again, you can highlight one so it kind of stands out. You can have the checkout button here. It would just be subscribe, right? And when they click this, it then goes to your hosted page. This is broken because it's a test one. But the really, really cool thing about this is you can just hit show code and grab this, it's HTML, and just put it on your site. So now what you've done is taken a ton of work away. You've created a product, you've created some plans, you've created a widget, you've integrated it with a payment provider, you take this code, embed it on your site, and now you have a website, you have the pricing page, and then you just have this widget. People can come here, click, and buy. I mean, this video is 21 minutes right now. If I were to distill down what I showed you, you could basically have an online SaaS business collecting payment in less than 15 minutes with setup. I really hope you enjoyed this video, but the goal of this video was for you to be able to create a product, create some plans, and get it on your site. And hopefully I helped you with that. Hopefully I explained what Zoho Subscriptions is and what it does. As always, please like, comment, subscribe. I'd love to hear comments on this video to see if I should take a different angle with this, maybe go a bit deeper with subscriptions. It's a pretty big app. There's all kinds of reports and stuff I didn't talk about. But what'll start happening on this homepage, I should mention, you'll start being able to see subscriptions and churn and signups, and Zoho does all of that for you. And most of it's self-explanatory. As always, feel free to join my office hours, give me feedback there, or just come meet me and see you in the next video.